to Uganda, money which we work very hard for here. We work for this money here. Please don't give that money to Uganda government. If you have helped Libya, you have sorted up Egypt, please sort Uganda. Ugandans are voiceless. They are voiceless because all the money you gave, the tanks have been bought. The police commander agreed with that. He said, yeah, the tanks have been bought by Britain's money. So we need you to stop that money. If you stop that money, the next step we shall find Museveni like Mubarak. You will see Museveni like Mubarak if you stop that money. And this money, you sign it in this parliament. We need you to say no. Please, parliament, do the right thing. This is a small global world. We are standing here. We need to say no to you giving money to Uganda government. No point for you to give money because Somalians are dying. No, that money is not going to Somalian people. It's going to his pocket. Ladies and gentlemen, let us see Ugandans like a human race. We should not be wiped out because we are poor. Ugandans are wiped out because they are poor. They have been degraded. Their lifestyle has been gone. People are crying. They can't afford even food. People can't afford medicine, let alone painkillers. We in England, you know how painkillers help us. They can't do without it. People are, doctors are suffering there. And recently, they went on strike. Teachers have gone on strike. You have got farmers have gone on strike. So what next? If you can't bury your dead, what next? Our job here is to highlight what's happening. The only difference is no journalist is going there. I challenge any journalist who is very tough. Tough journalists went to interview Osama bin Laden. Why can't you go there to interview this tyrant? Why can't you go there, fly tonight, and he is in South Africa now? He has burnt people. He is there alive and kicking. He's kicking because you are supporting him. The people have washed up their hands. They have given up. I stand here to represent those people. I stand here very firmly to represent those people. And those people, their lives are just the lives like yours and mine. If you walk away and you don't listen to what I said, then there's something wrong with your spirit. You must be shaken by what I'm telling you. The lives of Ugandans has been degraded to the extent over 25 years. And ladies and gentlemen, we stand here to tell the parliamentarians, please, table Uganda. Rather than seeking money because there is famine coming, or